Today we're going to take a look at auto-tracking of a moving object shot with a moving camera also using the roto panel. In this case we're going to be using a shot of the rarely seen event of a helpful teenager. So we'll begin by going to the roto panel and we're going to rough in a couple of mats, starting with a garbage mat that's going to encompass the trash can and our highly skilled actor. So let's get that into position here. And this doesn't have to be a super accurate sort of thing. We're just trying to make sure that trackers for the camera don't wind up on the can or on the actor. So I'm just going to go through the shot and kind of successively refine that going into the middle. And each time I go to a different frame, just take a look and see, you know, where are the spots that the mat is as far off, you know, at the farthest part off, and adjust those. And after you do that a couple of times with the usual spline interpolation, you'll get something that sticks reasonably well to our object. So there we go with a rough garbage mat to block the actor in the can out of the scene. So that's spline two here, our garbage mat. Now we're ready to add a moving object. So we're going to go over here and hit the add moving object. And now we're going to create another little mat that we actually want to have indicate the area for the trackers that we want to have. So we're going to put this fairly carefully onto the area of the can itself. And we want to make sure it doesn't get too far off. If it gets too far off at some point, we run the risk of having it wipe out all the trackers just in the space of a couple of frames. So we want to keep it kind of on track. Again, it doesn't have to be at all super accurate, but we want to make sure that we don't pick up stuff from the background or from the actor if possible. And we do want to be sure to pick up a bunch of stuff from the can itself. And you can see that due to the way the splining is done here, you know, there is some interaction each time we hit a key on some particular frame, you know, into the rest of the shot. That's why I keep scrubbing back through it. And we could go and adjust key types if we wanted in the graph editor, but it's really rarely worth the trouble. So there we have our mat for the object that we want to track. So now we're ready to go over and we'll go back to the main summary panel. And we'll run the auto tracker and have it whip through. And it's going to generate the trackers and assign them to either the background to generate the track for the camera, to the garbage area here so that we don't wind up with any problems from the actor, or assign trackers to the can itself so that we can generate a 3D track for the moving object itself. Now, we didn't do this super accurately, so we'll just scrub through the shot and see how we did. And if you look, you'll see that there are some little trackers sitting down here on the wheel, and we can just go and take those out. One of the things in 2011, by the way, is you can switch to a rectangular selection region if that works out handier for you. Now, you know, if we wanted, we could have set up a separate little garbage mat just for this wheel itself to pin this down a little more carefully. But again, not really worth the trouble. let's see, observation, the delete key often works very swiftly. So we can put it to work. Now it looks like we have even one back there on the background. So there we go with our set of trackers. Now let's go over to the solving panel. And we've got the object. We're going to switch over to the solving mode for the camera. And we're going to set it to tripod because it's tripod mode shot. So we're not going to get depth information from the background here. We are going to get the pan and tilt motion of the camera. For the object itself, we are going to get a 3D solve. There's only a limited amount of perspective shift available there. So we're going to hit the slow but sure button so that we can get the right solution. And also give it a little motion hint that says that the camera is moving sort of to the right around the object. And these two settings are to avoid a problem that's called inverted perspective, which can happen when there's very low perspective. Sometimes things that are close appear as if they're far and vice versa. And that's kind of a fundamental thing in the math. It just says if there's not any perspective at all, things can be rotating one way or the other way, and you can't tell at all whether you're a program or a person. So we're just giving it a little hint to get the solution that we want. So at this point, we are ready to go and get a solve. There we go. We have our initial solve. You'll see that there are a couple of points. We look in the top view over here, there are a couple of points that are kind of way out there. So we can go and take those out. They're clearly a hazard and represent some little piece of noise. And actually, let's go and just run the solve again. Now we can do a cleanup trackers to look for other sort of problems. Here there are some that are still have a higher error. We'll take those out, rerun. This is a typical kind of quick and dirty cleanup process. And we'll also look for some trackers that are right next to one another that have been seen in one part of the shot and then again later in the shot and get, you know, can get combined together. So we'll do that. Now we have our moving object there. Now we're ready to take a look at a coordinate system setup. So let's take a look at what the situation is here. We have actually a cloud of points here. These represent the trackers from the background, and they are far type points. They're just directions rather than having any associated distance. But we do have a 3D solve for the camera, or for the moving object out here. Now, the whole position of this complex could be moved around as a whole, as a unit, if we were so inclined, if we wanted to put something into the background scene. Here we're going to add something to the trash can, so we're not really going to be too concerned about the placement of the whole camera and trackers, how they are oriented or positioned. Instead, we're just going to be concerned about the separate coordinate system on the object itself. So there are two different ways to look at that, to do that. First, we're just going to set up the perspective window, and so far with the settings, the object's fairly far away, so we're going to increase the clipping distance so that we see everything properly. So now we have all these little marks that are on the moving object itself, as well as there are tracker marks on the background itself. The ones that we're concerned about are the ones on the trash can. So they're just going to zoom in a little bit more on that. So one approach that we could do is to take a whole collection of trackers on the side of the we could go and select a whole bunch of these and use a grid setting. We'll go up to the little higher so you can see this. Just select the two facets operation there and two vertices. And so this actually snapped the grid onto the side of the trash can. And we could use that to do that. That's kind of a quick and dirty way to do it. It would be great for demo purposes. A lot of people get confused on this whole thing. So let's do something that's a bit more worthwhile in general. And that's to go and set up a coordinate system properly using a couple of these points. So just like you'd set up a coordinate system for the camera itself if we had a 3D solve, we can set up a coordinate system using a couple of points on the side of the can. So I'll use a point here. We'll use one of these ones over here. And then another point down at the bottom here someplace. So I set up the coordinate system so that the main axis is going to run along this side of the trash can up here. And this other point down at the bottom is going to wind up being on the plane that represents the side of the box. So having done that, let's go and now we'll pick out another grid setting. Here, unfortunately, you can't see this. I'm going to select grid, then object mode grids, and then upward facing grid. So what I told SynthEyes was put a grid into the coordinate system of the object. So this is just so we can see the coordinate system that we just set up for that object. And you can see how it aligns with the origin of the moving object right at the first tracker that I selected. The x-axis of this grid and the object's coordinate system is out here through the second one, and this other one is on the same plane. So at this point I can go and we'll create a cylinder just right here on the side of the box here, and this kind of gives you a little idea of, you know, how good of a track there is when you have something kind of pointy like that. And now we can just we'll go back to the camera view. And you can see that we've stuck that right onto the side of the garbage can. So you can go and do, you know, whatever other effects you want to do to this. And this gives you some idea what it's like. We'll go and take a quick look at the quad view also. And you know, you can see up there, you know, this null is again located right at the location of that one tracker that we had selected. And you can see the object cylinder glued onto the side. And this whole cloud of points that moves along with the moving object, those are all the trackers that are attached to the garbage can itself. So there's a look at some object tracking for you. Often the object tracking does get done using supervised tracking, and that's really just the same as any other kind of supervised tracking. You know, as long as you have the object selected up here, the trackers that you create will be assigned to the object. And you can switch back and forth, create trackers on the camera, create trackers on, you know, one or more of the objects, whichever you want to do. And it's pretty straightforward. You can also, there's a separate tutorial on the website that shows you how you can move trackers back and forth from one object to another just using the drop down there. So take care and enjoy.